Saturday night coming to you. I want to be talking about some positive things today because I hate talking about negative things all the time. We're going to be talking about Star Citizen and some things that I think they're going on the right path with this game. I found out through forums, I don't know, I'll have to verify this, that apparently you can't buy military variants of vehicles on their store, which I think is great because they're trying to, I think, to my knowledge, they're trying to steer clear of a pay-to-win game, because that's how you kill a game, is when you sell power, because then the rich people will annihilate everyone else. Other things about Star Citizen, I'm looking forward to the 3.0 update. I want to be able to do missions, do ground combat, fly in planets. So that's some things I'm looking forward to. You can find me on Star Citizen. My hold is Boko Army, B-O-C-O Army. I'm also streaming on my Twitch, so you can see me play the game. So I'm going to be talking more in depth when I do my live streams of Star Citizen. Some more things about Star Citizen. A little bit of critiques about the combat. Right now, combat's how should I put it? Very light, fluffy, like you're playing patty cake sometimes with the enemy. Because you don't get very much solid hits with guns. Guns don't have enough oomph, I think. Missiles are fine when they hit, so I have no problem with them. It's just not very intuitive with the missiles, but whatever. Some other critiques, we're going to be talking about the 2.5 release. What I've noticed, the couple bugs I've noticed, is the AI, they stop actually fighting you. They actually go very slow. There's also a tremendous amount of lag I've noticed. Past that, I haven't seen anything else. I've been to Grimhex. That's a wonderful place to be. Definitely a pirate. You get a pirate feel for the game and how that atmosphere will be. You go out in the station. You can pull your gun out. You can kill players. I did so myself. As soon as you leave the airlocks, you can pull your gun out. So one match I kind of did. Not one match, but one instance I kind of pulled my gun out because a guy pulled a gun on me. And he walked away and I shot him in the back. It's like, don't pull a gun on me again. So, those are my takes on Star Citizen for the 2.5 update. Another thing I want to be talking about is the capital ships and what will they be like. I know they have on the dev branch the Idris frigate, and I'd love to see how that is implemented into the game. I want to know how that will play into combat, how that will play into missions, what the cost of it will be in-game, and other factors like that. Also, I'd like to know if you can hire AI crew for the thing. Because I would like that for just mundane systems like engineering. I'd like that for the big guns on the capital ship. Because if you're a pilot, I just want to be able to shoot the guns. Maybe the turrets as well. The turret defense, the point defense. It's probably an organization level item to get to acquire. So that's something to look forward to in the game. Another thing is also, another question I have to ask is ship-to-ship combat between these capital ships and how fighters will play a role in those space combat, because if it's essentially a huge flying fortress, I wonder how the fighters will play into that and how much damage they'll do once the shields are down, or if there'll be a threat at all to, say, a frigate. What I worry about, because what kind of happens in the game now is, say you're winning the combat, people will quantum leap out of the area, right, away from you. So if you're in a bigger ship that can take more hits, how does the quantum jump drive work for bigger ships? Is it slower? Is it faster? Those are some questions I have for that. Also, the Bingo Carrier. I wonder how that is going to play out. That is a huge, massive ship. So we'll see in the future, because I think they're planning on releasing that, or at least being done with the majority of the work in October. So we'll see more of those when that comes out in October. So that's kind of my rant, my positive rants and criticism of Star Citizen in its current state. I recommend getting the game, actually. It's a very good game. I actually have a few hours playing the game myself from both 2.4 to 2.5. That's my experience with the game. Like and subscribe, and this is Liberty Knight signing off.